The Father and the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning to all of you and welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. My dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who renew the world through mysteries beyond all telling, grant, we pray, that your church may be guided by your eternal design and not be deprived of your help in this present age. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, Lo, I am about to create a new heavens and a new earth. The things of the past shall not be remembered or come to mind. Instead, there shall always be rejoicing and happiness in what I create. For I create Jerusalem to be a joy, and its people to be a delight. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and exult in my people. No longer shall the sound of weeping be heard there, or the sound of crying. No longer shall there be in it an infant who lives but a few days, or an old man who does not round out his full lifetime. He dies a mere youth, who reaches but 100 years, and he who fails of 100 shall be thought accursed. They shall live in the house they build, and eat the fruit of the vineyards they plant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will extol you, O Lord, for you drew me clear and did not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you brought me up from the nether world. You preserved me from among those going down into the pit.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Sing praise to the Lord, you his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger lasts but a moment, a lifetime his goodwill. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn, rejoicing.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Hear, O Lord, and have pity on me. O Lord, be my helper. You change my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, forever will I give you thanks.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Please stand.
Glory to you, Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ.
Seek good and not evil, so that you may live, and the Lord will be with you.
Glory to you, Word of God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At the time, Jesus left Samaria for Galilee, for Jesus himself testified that a prophet has no honor in his native place. When he came into Galilee, the Galileans welcomed him, since they had seen all he had done in Jerusalem at the feast, for they themselves had gone to the feast. Then he returned to Cana in Galilee, where he had made the water wine. Now there was a royal official whose son was ill in Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus had arrived in Galilee from Judea, he went to him and asked him to come down and heal his son, who was near death. Jesus said to him, "Unless you people see signs and wonders, you will not believe." The royal official said to him, "Sir, come down before my child dies." Jesus said to him, "You may go, your sons will live." The man believed what Jesus said to him and left. While the man was on his way, his slaves met him and told him that this boy would live. He asked them when he began to recover. They told him the fever left him yesterday about 1 in the afternoon. The father realized that just at that time Jesus had said to him, "Your son will live." And he and his whole household came to believe. Now this was the second sign Jesus did when he came to Galilee from Judea. Ready, friends, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Nung babasa ko yung Ebanghelyo, nakababasa pa lang natin, I had some questions. Sapagkat yung binasa nating Ebanghelyo, there is a part in it that resonates very closely to people like us. Nasa business po kasi kami ng preaching. Nasa business po kasi kami ng evangelizing. Nasa ang goal po namin, convince yung mga tao, makapreach yung salita ng Diyos. At mapatuloy at mapalalim yung pananampalataya na makausap namin. Baga, the moment that we stand here, and then we open our mouths, and then we preach, yun po yung goal, mapalalim yung pananampalataya sa Panginoon. And we are in that business. Kaya nga po, nung binasa ko yung Ebanghelyo ngayon, and heard the Lord complaining, "Kayo talaga mga taong kayo, unless you people see the sign, you will not believe." No? Parang ang hirap-hirap nyo ng papaniwalain o maniwala. No? And the question for me is that, kung yung Panginoon nga was already making miracles left and right, preaching left and right, eh ang dami-dami pa rin mga bumabatikos at ang dami pa rin mga hindi naniniwala at ang dami-dami pa rin mga pumupuna, eh paano pa kaya kami? No? We don't make miracles at least on the same level as the Lord. We don't do that. We simply preach. Papaniwalaan ba kaya? That's a challenge, no? And I think that is a very valid question. Any friends, nasa mundo po tayo na ang daming credibility issues. Nasa mundo po tayo na madalas hindi mo na alam kung ano yung paniniwalaan, kung ano yung totoo o ano yung hindi. Ano ba talaga yung mas matinong baksina? Yung vaccine ba ay kapag tinurukan ako ay ano ba mangyayari sa akin? Mayroon nagsasabi na yung isa ay tawag nito, magkaka-allergy ka. May mga balita naman na, ang dami, di ba, no? And that's the reason why ang baba-baba ng confidence sa immunization dito sa Pilipinas. Sapagkat ang dami-daming nagsasalita at hindi mo na malaman kung ano yung paniniwalaan. We have a problem of certitude dito sa ating komunidad, sa ating society, sa ating bansa. Ano ba talaga yung totoo, sister? No? Ano ba talaga yung totoo? Makakasama ba yan? Makakabuti? Ang dami-dami nagsasalita, no? Just Google it. Just look at the YouTube sa mga Facebook account ninyo. Hindi mo na malaman eh. Kanina po, before, because I often met with our workers every Monday para konting pep talk, konting tanong, konting direction, I asked them the question, ilan po ba sa inyo, and I think I was only talking to the facilities management group, siguro nasa 25 sila, sabi ko, ilan po kaya sa inyo yung kapag ka-available na yung vaccine ay magpapaturok? Iisa lang ang nagtaas ng kamay. At nung tinanong ko, ang sagot sa akin, hindi po kasi namin alam kung ano yung totoo. Ang dami-daming nagsasalita. Ang dami-daming kung ano-ano yung mga tawag nito, kung ano-ano yung mga posisyon. We don't know. We have a problem of truth, at least yung maliit na truth, dito sa ating society. Hindi lang po yan sa baksina, sa maraming issue pa po. Kaya ang hirap ng tawag nito mag-preach sapagkat di marin malaman kung yun ay lumalalim sa kanila. If it's happening in our time, it was also happening in the time of the Lord. Yung kalahati po nun, maliban doon sa tawag nito, doon sa ang dami-daming mga nagsasalita, ang dami-daming nagpo-post, ang dami-daming mga, yung mga mema sa bilang post kaagad, no? It affects, no? Yung pangalawa po, yung kahati nito, ay yung believability. Meron pong regression eh, nag-diminish yung tiwala sa mga institusyon, gobyerno, simbahan, bumagsak, no? Yung believability nitong mga institusyon na dati-rati kapag sinabi mo ang utos ng pare, hindi mababali. Ayun po, natcha-challenge na yun. And rightly so naman po, no? Hindi naman sa lahat ng pagkakataon. So we have also a problem of credibility. Ngayon, pagtugmain mo yung dalawa na yon, may problema ka sa credibility, ang dami-dami pang mga nagsasalita, ay magulo talaga. And that's the reason one, my dear friends, hopefully, one of our prayers sa ating Lenten season ay yung magkaroon tayo ng disposisyon ng paghahanap ng katotohanan sa ating mga puso at sa tulong ng ating Panginoon. It's a difficult task, no? Napakahirap po na tawag nito, maabot yun. But at some point, hindi naman po tayo po pwedeng hindi maniwala. Di ba? Lahat tayo naghahanap pa rin ng mapangahawakan, naghahanap pa rin tayo ng mapagsasandalan, naghahanap pa rin po tayo na kapag nagsalita sa ganito, chances are totoo yan, no? Naghahanap pa rin po tayo na kapag nag-preach ng ganito, alam natin na hindi tayo binobolan yan. Alam natin na may laman yan. May totoo yan, no? And also at the same time, another challenge to us is that before we speak up, I think the Lenten season is asking us to pause for a while. Totoo ba yan? Makakabuti ba yan? No? Kapag ba ako'y nagsalita, makakadagdag ako sa gulo o makakapagpalinaw? Yung mga salita ko ba ay makakatulong na maliwanagan o mas lalong gugulo kapag ako ay bumukas pa ng aking bibig? These are things, my dear friends, that has something to do with the gospel that we heard today. Ang reklamo ng Panginoon, kayo talagang mga tao kayo, unless you see a sign, you will not believe. But the Lord knows how difficult it is to believe the truth, not only in His time, lalong-lalo na sa panahon natin. That is a challenge for us, but the grace of God, the truth, the way, the truth, and the life will continue to guide us. So for those who seek the truth, you will find it, and the truth will also find us. And when that happens, then we know that the grace of God is with us. Kindly all stand. Confident that when we pray with faith to God the Father, He will respond to our request with open-hearted generosity, we now present before Him our needs, and let your response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. that the Church throughout the world may be a symbol of Christ's healing work by her care for those who are sick in body, mind, and spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That doctors, nurses, and those who care for the sick may show the compassion and gentleness of Jesus in caring for the least of his brethren. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this season of Lent may be a time of healing and reconciliations for families and communities of people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the suffering may receive comfort and support from their families, friends, and neighbors. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our beloved dead may enjoy forever the reward of their faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We continue to pray for all the devotees of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, that the Lord may continue to bless them, keep them safe and healthy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for all our frontliners who continue to sustain us and help us in this time of pandemic. We also pray for the guidance and enlightenment of our leaders, both in the civil and the ecclesiastical area. That the Lord may continue to bless them, inspire them, and keep them safe. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now we pause for a while, and in silence, you may now offer your personal intentions. Heavenly Father, help us to go on trusting you and to have faith in the healing power of your Son who binds up all our wounds. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May we receive, O Lord, we pray, the effects of this offering dedicated to you, so that we may be cleansed from all earthly ways and be renewed by growth in heavenly life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We'll lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for through bodily fasting, you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, and bestow both virtue and its rewards to Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life in the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Socrates, our Archbishop, Fidelis, our Auxiliary Bishop, Gerard, the Master of the Order, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Please stand.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer to one another the sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Peace, peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
My dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, behold our Lord Jesus Christ, our healer, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
By the blood of Christ, bring me to everlasting life.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May your heavenly gifts, O Lord, we pray, which you bestow as a heavenly remedy to your people, not bring judgment to those who receive them, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata. Let us turn to Saint Joseph, who brings comfort to the afflicted and consolation for the sick, to help us in our needs. Let us say together, Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Saint Joseph, you saved the Savior from death in the hands of Herod, save the world from the death of COVID-19, we pray.
Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Saint Joseph, you suffered to see the child and his mother born in poverty in a manger. Stay with us as we endure our crosses of hunger, joblessness, and sickness due to COVID-19, we pray.
Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Saint Joseph, you heard the prophetic words of Simeon to Mary that her heart would be pierced by the sword. Beg God to bless our efforts to end the pandemic through the vaccination program and observance of health protocols, we pray.
Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Saint Joseph, you suffered protecting the child and his mother in exile in Egypt. Protect and shield from harm those who care for our brethren who are sick and dying, we pray.
Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Saint Joseph, you were anxious when the child was lost for 3 days in the temple. Turn our COVID-19 fears, anxieties, and depression into hope, joy, and peace, we pray.
Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Let us pray, Saint Joseph, come to our aid in these times of anguish and anxiety. Take us under your care as we place our trust in you now and forever.
Amen. Please be seated for some announcement. The summer feast of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag will be on April 21, 2021. Novena Masses will begin on April 12 until April 20, 2021. The schedule of Masses will be at 6 a.m., 7:30 a.m., 9 a.m., 10:30 a.m., 12 noon, and 4:30 p.m., and will be streamed live through the social platforms of the Minor Basilica and via Manaoag Dominican Radio 102.7 FM. We cordially invite you to participate in the feast and the Novena Masses. If you wish to sponsor one or several Masses during this feast and Novena, you may approach our Basilica personnel in the religious stores and Mass intention encounters. Thank you. Please stand.
Before I give the final blessing, maraming salamat po sa pagdalaw ninyo sa Minor Basilica of the Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag at sa pakikisa ninyo sa banal na misa. Maraming salamat po. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord through one another.
Thanks be to God.
We shall now say the prayer for the blessing po ng mga may sakit dito o kaya nasa bahay. And then afterwards, we shall say the prayer para sa blessing ng inyong mga religious articles. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
God, our Almighty Father, by your blessing, you give us strength and support in our frailty. Turn with kindness toward our sick brothers and sisters. Free them from all illness and restore them to good health through the intercession of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, so that in the sure knowledge of your goodness, they will gratefully bless your holy name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In memory of the mysteries of the life, death, and resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, and to the honor and glory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Christ, Mother of the Church, Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, may these rosaries, images, and candles, oil, and other religious articles be blessed and made holy. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.